Hello everyone. Today, March 20, is World Storytelling Day, and all through the day, we have been celebrating it by reading various sugilanon, the Binisaya word for stories, called from all over Negros Oriental. I'd like to contribute to this celebration by reading to you a children's story I have written titled The Great Little Hunter, which is about a boy who is afraid of monsters but learns to be friends with his fears. To complement my story are the wonderful illustrations done by Dumaguete artist Hersley Casero. Here is The Great Little Hunter. Once, when he was little, when the night was growing deep and he was not at all ready for bed.
"No, no, no,"
the boy whimpered. His father told him his secret name. "You are Ngayam," said his father. And the boy asked,
"What does it mean?"
"It means you are a great hunter, a mangangayam."
"What does a mangangayam do?"
His father told the boy that a mangangayam is brave, a brave boy that hunts, a boy that hunts monsters, a boy that is never, never afraid. "It is his destiny to be a great hunter of monsters," his father gently said, bidding him sweet dreams.
"I am Ngayam,"
said the boy, in the sudden dark of his room, liking very much his secret name. And before he closed his eyes that night, he saw that the moon outside his window was shining brighter tonight. And somewhere in the distance, he heard the crook, crook, crook of strange birds calling for the moon. And then, almost all at once, there grew everywhere all kinds of trees and vines and grass. And the little boy's bed was like a tiny boat in this vast sea of green. He gulped.
"I am Ngayam,"
said the boy. And the trees and the vines and the grass stopped growing. The boy decided to jump off his bed and waded through the thick grass. And in the distance, there was a rough sound of rustling leaves. And the boy gulped. And the shadows moved, and the boy saw a wak-wak, a bird-like creature flying low.
"Cree! Cree! Cree!"
the wak-wak said.
I am the hunter,"
the little boy replied. In the moon's light, the wak-wak dipped its wings, and they became friends. Together, they went deeper into the grass. And soon the shadows moved again, and the boy saw a sigbin, a dog-like creature growling behind an acacia tree. "Grrr, grrr, grrr," the sigbin said.
I am the hunter,
the little boy replied. In the moon's light, the Sigbin yelped and panted, and they became friends. Together, they all went deeper into the grass. And soon the shadows moved again, and the boy saw a tikbalang, a horse-like creature chasing butterflies.
Mie, mie, mie,
the tikbalang said.
I am the hunter,
the little boy replied. In the moon's light, the tikbalang whined and brayed, and they became friends. Together, they all chased the fireflies and went deeper into the grass. Deeper and deeper they went, the hunter and his new friends, laughing and chasing the shadows under the moon. Soon the boy said,
I am tired, and yawned a great huge yawn. And in a sleepy voice, he muttered, I am the hunter of monsters.
Yes, you are, said his friends. And in the light of the waning moon, the wakwak and the sigbin and the tikbalang carried him back to the bed that was like a tiny boat in a vast sea of green, where the boy dreamed of monsters and hunting. And the morning smile on his father's proud face. The end.